Good morning, everybody. Nice that you are here. I think my main task is to keep you awake, entertain you a little bit after a hard and hot night. So, yes. I'm, as usually, talking about plans if I'm at a Debian conference, and I hope that I previously made it some good introduction, what are good reasons to have plans and what they are. And today I want to become a little bit more verbose about the tools we are using. However, we'll give a short introduction, and then I come to the techniques we are using, about meta packages, Web Sentinel. I also dive a little bit into the team analysis we are doing. I have some tiny scripts and queries for the UDD, and I also want to tell you what we are doing to reach out to newcomers. And in the last part, I will talk a little bit about what we plan to do. Okay, I'll give a very short introduction because it might be helpful for you. For me, this is a view onto Debian. You have a lot of packages which are maintained by several people, and a user is happy to install it on his computer. The problem is Debian has, I don't have the current numbers, but 30,000 or even more packages. And if a new user gets install media for Debian, he looks probably like this and has no idea where the applications are in Debian which are useful for him and what packages to install for the specific tasks the user has. And a possible solution for this problem is that we create some kinds of focus groups on this large pool, which is just, for example, here Scholar Linux or Debian Edu for schools. We have Debian Med, which is for biologists and medicine. And we have Debian GIS for Geographic Information System. We have also Debian Astro. We have DebiChem. We have Debian Science. So we have special groups which have the task to provide Debian in a comfortable way to a specific target group. For one instance is we create in the Debian Med blend, we create a task Med Bio, which is targeting at the biologist who is working on DNA sequencing and so on. And one of the tasks of the Debian Med blend is biology, and there you see for biologists quite common softwares. It's way more, we have more than 500 packages, but just for examples. So everything is in and you get to focus on the packages which are useful for your task. And every blend is doing this in a similar way. So in my opinion, a blend, or Debian also in general, is kind of a bridge between upstream developers and the user. So we should be the connection between them, and we should try to tie a solid network of Debian developers and upstream developers and users. In the specific field of blends, you have kind of experts in some fields, and the users are also experts, and to build this bridge between them is kind of an interesting thing. The rationale is that the experts are happy if somebody has a look on their build system and packaging and so on, because they are focusing on their own topic, and we somehow see fancy things in their build system, so we can give them good advice. And usually upstream anticipators, enhancements and security audit or whatever a Debian developer can provide. And what we are finally doing in the Debian Med team, we are trying to teach upstream developers how to create packages. And this works out quite well because I'm personally not an expert in this field. I'm a physicist. I don't have any idea about this biology stuff. And if the person who develops the software creates the Debian package, he has good means to test if it's doing what it should do, and so providing the knowledge how to package is quite a good idea. And my idea is that if we penetrate specific word fields with Linux, then it makes it even more acceptable in general, because if a person who has good experiences on his work with Linux, it might consider it very useful also at home and perhaps in the family, and so I think if we could penetrate more work fields, we could get some rise in the number of Debian installations in general. So the point is, we try to attract people to use Blends, and on one hand, these are developers, and we need to make sure that we provide good methods, so the acceptance to use this is way higher. And in Blends, we have some kind of simple way to categorize software. These categories are in the Blends terminology tasks, or task files, and these are not exclusive tasks. So, for instance, we share in the biology task some packages with Debian, with Debichem team, because they also are investigating molecules, and there are certain overlaps between different tasks of different Blends, which is quite good. And so this is are not exclusive categorizations, but we one software can be used in different fields. These tasks are also some kind of key documentation feature, because I show later that it's very easy, if you have once categorized your packages, to display them on web pages and have all the information assembled in one place. We have also quality assurance pages where we list bugs, or we have also some page where we can watch the Debian external health status, which means we are checking if there's new upstream versions available or not. From the user point of view, the web pages we are creating provide a very simple means to do translations. You just need to click a button to provide a translation for your known languages. And these web pages, which are created out of the task, can be very helpful to promote the software and give the user a means how to create a complete working environment. So the thing we are trying to approach is that we can raise the user interest by providing ready-to-install software in his specific work field. Ready-to-install means we create meta packages, and it's in principle one-click experience to install everything what's inside Debian for this work field. This is the meaning of, you have seen the lenses which put the focus on the thing. This is kind of bringing the user very easily to this place. The user asks me, how can I install all this stuff? And I say, just install the meta package and you are done. What about the Blends features in general? So we define a set of dependency relations and turn these into installable codes by the tool I will show you. This installable code are the meta packages, and we can do the online demonstration in the so-called Web Sentinel. And this is also a major point, a Blend is not only some technique, some code, it's also a team behind. And I'm trying to stress this point very much, because it's finally the people you have contact to and which you can ask, and this is a very good resource we should not underestimate. So what about these meta packages? There is a package which is called Blends Dev, and this is dealing with some task files, and it does the following things automatically. In the task file, you specify depends and recommends relations, And BlendStef is verifying if the package exists. And if a package is not existing in main, it will be turned to suggests, which means the meta package is installable in main. And if you have maybe some external or some local package mirror, or some packages are in non-free or so, then you can install even with minus minus suggests, and then you get everything that this one usage. In any case, BlendStef makes sure that the package is policy conform and the package exists. It creates a Debian control file automatically, and by thus, this control file contains all the meta packages which were defined in the task files, and it also creates task cell control file, which you can use with task cell. By the way, feel free to ask questions if something is unclear. It's perfectly fine if you interrupt me, and I'm just telling you. The mics are there. So how it is working? You just use a very simple rules file. You just include the rules file which comes with BlendStef. That's all you need to do. It's actually using DH, and you can also use some overriders, but in principle, that's not necessary. Then you provide just a stub of a control file. The whole control file will be auto-generated. There's also a line in it, don't edit it, because it's auto-generated. And this stub contains only information about the source package on the header of the usual control file. And there are examples which you can easily use, or you can sneak into a random Blends source package. So use Debian Astro or Debian GIS or Debian Med, or so download the source and you will see a working example. That's very easy. There's also an example for a task file you could copy for the first moment. It looks like this. So if you start a new Blend, by the way, there's also a documentation which gives hints how to start a new Blend. You can copy an example task. You can copy a README file which has some template, and then you can edit this task file, which consists of a task name, a description, short description, long description, as you know it from every normal Debian control file. In principle, you can imagine that the task file is a control file, which is glued together with all tasks. Then you define depends, recommends, and suggests. If you want to suggest only packages, please make sure you add a new line between all the depends and recommends. That's important for the tool, but these are details I will not undergo. If you have problems, come to the mailing list and ask. A new thing is the format line. We now have defined a new format. I'll come back to this soon. And then you do this for every task you want to provide. And as I said, there are working examples hanging around for the Blends, and it should be easy to copy. So once you have defined all this, you just say make dist, as you say, to create some kind of source tarball, and this is doing all the useful stuff. If a package is not in testing, it goes to suggests, as I said, and there is also one meta package that is called all. This has a special meaning, and the final purpose is that we want to get Blends into the Debian installer, which is not yet the case. I have an open bug from 2003, so 15 years ago. And we really, really, really hope that this will happen for the booster release. And so this all meta packages, you can define what meta packages of your Blend are really important, and they are installed immediately, and the other are free for the user. And it's this make this also creates a task cell input file. What about this new format? Formerly, it was the meta packages were defined that they do not contain any depends. They only contain recommends for very good reasons, which I do not want to discuss here. But it turned out that in some very special cases, we need hard depends, and it was not possible with format 1.0. And so format 1.1 will keep depends as depends and not degrade them to recommends. The format line changes, and so depends remain as it is. It's available since BlendStef 0.7. So the task cell files are created as well, as I said. It includes task cell description files. And as I said, I really hope that we get this included into the Buster installer. Or Buster, it's called Buster, sorry. Yeah, and it installs this meta package. Okay. Moreover, some not so important feature, but I like it anyway, is that BlendStef 0.7 has some method to add some data files about package statistics. It's just create a JSON file which contains all the previous versions and the packages which are in depends, recommends, and suggests. So you can create some graphs. I will show some in a moment. And it also helps maintaining the change log, because if we change the task, at least I'm very lazy to maintain the Debian change log, and this can generate the change log with all the changes you have added compared to the previous version of the source package of your blend. This is, for instance, a graph I generated with these JSON files. It displays a Debian Meet task, or at least a selected task of the Debian Meet blend. You see over the time from 2002 until 2018, the number of packages in the biology task was rising a lot. Other tasks were rising not that steeply for certain reason I do not want to comment, but you can create this kind of 3D graphs if you have all this data. And this data is created, or you have means to create this data in your in this BlendStef framework. So the Web Sentinel is a way to somehow show off what we have. And it just provides information about packages in one task. So it's assembled on one web page. The information is gathered from UDD. UDD is the ultimate Debian database. It contains all the metadata you can imagine about packages, the package descriptions, translations, dependencies, and upstream versions, and whatever. It's everything. That's why the name is Ultimate Debian Database. The task pages are more user-oriented, so if somebody is asking me what are you providing in this blend, I usually point to the task pages, and it's more or less a key entry point for users, because it provides a quick overview of what's inside Debian regarding a specific work field. It might contain a to-do list. I will show immediately one example. And it also turned out to be a quality assurance tool for developers as well. So I'll now show you one of the task pages. This is, for instance, the biology task of the Debian Meet blend. We have, for every package, we have the package name, short description, homepage, who is the maintainer, who is the last uploader, is the package up to date, is the translation available. For instance, I'm showing you currently the German locale, so if you can read it, then it's not yet translated, and if it's not translated, then you get a yellow button on the right side, translate description. And if I would be motivated to translate it, I could do it. I don't do it because I leave the translation to other interested persons. And it's anyway questionable to translate scientific descriptions, because most scientists can speak English. But for instance, if you look at the Debian games blend, it would be really nice if the games description would be translated. You can also upload the screenshots here. We have some packages with screenshots, not so many, but you can scroll down here and see some different things. For instance, you also see if there are new upstream versions. So this page says, oh, this is not fully up to date. You could check what is the new version by moving the mouse here and see, we are at version 16.0 and upstream at 17.0, so there is some work to do. This is something which is more my field of tasks, a little bit hard in this case. And you have also some screenshot to see here. So this is something I really want the users to do. These pages are user-oriented, and if the user decides to provide a screenshot, he can just click here and upload a screenshot, and this goes to the main Debian infrastructure. So not only these pages will profit from this, but all Debian tools that are consuming screenshots will get the screenshots. Same with the translations. If a translation is provided, also apt gets the translation, and so on. Specifically for the scientific packages, we have citations there. This is very important because in the beginning I told you that we try to build a bridge between upstream and their users. And if upstream sees, oh, they are quoting my publication, that's a good thing. And the users can read it here at this place with the links. And so upstream is happy that we are packaging the software and we provide some service for upstream and the users. And I also told you that we have kind of a to-do list. We have here Debian packages in the new queue, which is, there are some packages we have packaged which are hanging in the new queue. And, oh, there are many. And we have some packages which have started the packaging in Git and are not yet finished for whatever reason. So what the user sees, they are working on this. Maybe I ask if I can help to get this happen, or I can provide some input, or the user can say, well, this would be really interesting for me. Could you please package this, or could you please finalize the package? In general, I must say, I was hoping way more for user interaction, that users come to me and say, please, could you do this or that for me? It does not happen, even if I know the users next to my office and tell them, please, if you tell me something, I can probably do something for you. I have no idea why this is not happening, but maybe it's some kind of this, if you are in the proprietary software world, people approach you with advertising and push you stuff, ready-made stuff, and push it on you, and we are just, you should join us and ask for something, and then we can do something for you, but I will not spend my time to run behind users and ask them or push them on it. I have other things to do. Okay. Well, these were the task pages. And these task pages are generated automatically from the task file once a day for every blend, for every task. So this you don't need to care. You just need to define one recommends file name or depends package name and depends file name or suggests file name, package name, and then this is generated. So you just give one package name and all the meta information is drained from the ultimate Debian database. So we have also kind of bugs pages, which is more developer oriented, so who tries to fix bugs. And the idea why I think is the good thing to have the existing bugs in certain work fields is that if I'm a user in this work field, I'm probably the right person to fix a specific bug. And so we try to attract competent people to specific bugs. And it's just an attempt to make Blends more relevant for this QA means. I show the bug pages, it is here. It's I found some means to categorize the tasks. This is the number over there is not the number of bugs, but it mixes a little bit the severity of the bug. And so if you look here into this, for instance, we take a smaller one in dental practice. If we have not so many packages, there is only one bug. It's even tagged patch. It's also not really maintained by the Debian Med team, but some photo tool. It's for dentists taking a photo of your teeth. So this is not so heavy, but we have a lot of bugs where we have a lot of packages, for sure. And then we have some kind of color code. So start with the red ones. The green ones are not so heavy, and the yellow ones. And you see if there are patches, and you can go there and check what thing you can fix. And I would be really happy if somebody would go to the specific work. We have also this for games, and so if you want to fix a bug in games, go to task page, check it, and then you find some targets to fix, maybe here at DevConf. That would be nice. So, what about team analysis? There was, when I had my first talk about Blends and Debian Med, I wanted to answer the question, who is member of the team? Yeah, that's a hard question. We have, at that time in Aliad, now in Salsa, we have people who have permission to commit to the team, but these permissions, there's nothing. Some people never commit, some people frequently commit. But who is in the team? And I was trying to find an answer how to estimate the number of active contributors and saying who is active on the mailing list, who uploads packages and fixes bugs, who commits to Git, and how many contributors we have per package. The last question is specifically important if you look at this graph. It's the following. In the first column displays, or the most left column displays, the packages which are get only commits in the version control system by a single maintainer. I removed some noise so that you need at least to do 5 commits. If it's a random commit, some NMU or so, I do not want to calculate because this is just noise. So what we see in the Debian Med case is that more than 350 packages are only maintained by a single person, which is not good because this is not really a team. It's way better in the packaging Perl team, where only a minority of packages is maintained by a single person. We have different examples, different teams. This is just a contrast. So our goal should be that we get the shape of the Perl team, that packages usually have 3, 4, or 5 maintainers who at some point in time commit to this package. This would be some kind of ideal situation. And I need to admit also that if we have 2 committers to some package in Debian Med team, it's the usual pattern is that somebody started to package something, left the team, and I took over. These are the 2 persons who are contributing. So these two people are also a little bit fake. It's just one person. Yeah, so we need more contributors because the more eyes are looking on a package, the better. Oops. No, sorry. This is the next graph about the uploaders. Here, in this example, I think the Debian Med is performing the good thing. And the, it's just a random example, the packaging of the XFCE desktop environment. We have other examples. What you see here is, well, if you forget this very active person, the top uploader of DebianMe team, you see that the baseline of the graph is settled by a lot of people. So it's not only one person who is maintaining all this stuff. In the XFCE case, you see in the last 4 years, it's only one person who contributed. So it's actually not really a team. It's one person with some support of others. And in this case, I'm very happy that we have more people contributing to the team uploads. We have similar graphs for bugs and so on. And if you are running some teams, not necessarily blend, neither PKG Perl nor Debian XFCE are blends. We can create these graphs as well. If you want me to do this, just tell me. So I also found some means which just helped me to do simple SQL queries. That's just a script, not documented, not published, but very helpful, and I can, if you are interested, I can document it and publish it a little bit more visible. UDD is a very cool tool. It provides the translations, and all the features I'm mentioning here, I've written originally for Blend's purposes, and they are taken over into Debian in general. So DDTP is the translations. The translations formerly were not contained in the UDD. Now they are a very basic part inside UDD. We have the content of the new queue is inside UDD. I included the screenshots you have seen. We have also, I call it Blend's prospective packages. This is what you'd seen, what you have seen on our to-do list. So if you mention a package where you just created the packaging in Git, it is passed from Git, and you get the information in UDD. And it is, if you put it in the task file, then it's showing up on the Web Sentinel. We have also the upstream metadata. This is basically the publications I have shown you. So more a scientific thing, but there are other upstream metadata which can be stored in UDD. And we have for the DebianMe team some specific things, some ontologies, which are also stored in UDD. And all the Blend's task content is inside UDD as well, so you can easily join the tables and gather the information you need with a single query. This is very handy. So for instance, before I create the meta packages, I want to make sure that every package that was created by the team is mentioned in at least one task. And I have a query which lists all packages that are not mentioned in any task and say, oh, I need to add this package to this task, this package to this task, or I blacklist. So this is kind of a nifty tool, which I'm using specifically for the Debian Science team, which is not so structured. And then I see, this maintainer forgot to add this new mathematics tool to the mathematics task, or this new data plotting tool to this one. And so this helps a lot to make sure that everything the team is doing is really mentioned there. Then I have a query where I sort the packages of a task according to their popcorn value, and add the one column if there is an AutoPKG test or not. This is specifically helpful for my Outreachy student. She is currently doing the video stream, and then I can pick from this list. She is writing AutoPKG tests, and we want to cover the more used packages first. And so it just provides a list what's a useful target for the next test. Very simple one. And what I'm also doing is I'm sorting all the packages of the Blend according to their latest upload. I'm doing this specifically every second year before we have a release. So I say, well, I think we should at least one upload per release. And if there are packages not touched a long time, it might be that the watch file is outdated and we have outdated software. And I check the homepage and check the watch file and check Lintian problems. And currently we need to touch every package anyway to move the VCS fields from Elliot to Salsa, and this script is quite handy. So I start with the packages from 2014, 15, 16, and just work down the list of the old non-TET packages and update them to recent policy and whatever. It's also quite healthy. And also we have a list of upgradable packages, which is also a nice tool to see, we should do this or that. It's kind of redundant information. You get it at several places, but with this script, I get it very focused on the things I'm really interested in. Yeah, so far for the tools, these tiny tools. If you are interested or you have ideas what you want to do with UDD, and then just tell me. About the outreach, I'm very keen on having a good team, and so I do some project which is called Mentoring of the Month. It's just getting new people in. I reported about this in Switzerland and will not go very much into detail. If you want to know more, just ask me. The thing is that because we are doing this kind of mentoring, we got in DebianMed 38 DMs and IDs, which is some kind of special, because I always say DebianMed is not really important for Debian. We are a very, very small topic, but we gathered for Debian 19 Debian developers only because the project exists. That means an unimportant project inside Debian gathers a lot of Debian developers. This is about 2% of the Debian developers we have. And they also reach out into different fields. So it's very motivating for people that they find friends inside Debian at first, and then they come to Debian. So this is my argument for you to reach out to people in your work fields, create a blend, or just make a small group to attract other people. And 14 of these 19 newcomers are staying active inside DebianMed. So it's a very healthy thing to reach out for people. The time I spend for this mentoring is definitely worth the effort. And well, I can also learn from the students, because I've read the documentation 20 years ago. So this is very efficient, and spreading the knowledge from the mentor to the student is very fine. And we also have a strong connection to upstream, because we frequently teach upstream developers to package and work on the MUM thing. I'm also offering sponsoring for people who are working in any blend. We have frequently people who are packaging interesting software, but they don't find a sponsor for the package. And I make sure they understand the blend framework, they make sure that the package is mentioned on the task page, this is my requirement, then I know they have understood the blend principle, and then I sponsor, not before. So what are the blend features for blends? Well, we like to enhance the web layout of these task pages. We need a better web layout. Did I say that the web layout should be enhanced? Okay, I think I did it. We could add some more info, report overview, maybe even Ubuntu bugs are interesting. And this is all easy to do, just somebody needs to do it. And we want to do it with a little bit better layout. Do we have volunteers for the layout? Please raise your hand now or later. Okay. Yeah, and we try to make the Blends code more flexible. So in the Blends dev, Ole has written some Python module which is planned to become enhanced, and we are working on different stuff. It's a little bit of a shame I did not wrote so much code in this general Blends stuff anymore, because I'm very occupied with single packages. I don't know how to enhance this a little bit, but there are luckily there are other people who took over this, like Ole and others who became a bit involved in this, or more than a bit involved. So here is the link to the general blends documentation, which explains the sense of blends in general, all the techniques, hopefully all the techniques, if the documentation is up to date. At least it has no Elliott links anymore. And it also explains how to create a new blend, what are the criteria to create a new blend, what pitfalls might be there. Yeah, and you find my talk, as always, on my talks page. And I hope that the blend sum will rise more and more, and you start contributing, or we have fun with your contribution or continuous fun to work together with us. That's all of my talk, and the session is now open for questions. Yeah. Are there any questions? Did I maintain to keep you awake in the morning hour? Please raise your hand if you are awake. So, no hands raised. Who is not awake? So, nobody? Then can just stop. We have 2 minutes left. I can go a little bit more in detail with these pages here. I always like to show this. If you want to do a translation, oops. I can show you how it works, translate description, then you go to this DDTP deviant.net is maybe good. It's good that I have shown this. It leads to DDTP.deviant.net, but it should be translation deviant.org meanwhile, as far as I know. I need to check this. Upload screenshot. So, you can, there is screenshots.debian.net, and you fire up the package, do a screenshot according to the advice that is given here. Oh, there is some general advice, and then you can add a screenshot there. We can have also a look at some other blends. All are at blends.debian.org. Let's have a look at games. And there is tasks, and there is a task finest. This is most probably the most interesting task. You see in this blend more or higher popcorn values than in the scientific stuff, and you have the games people are quite behind screenshots. It looks good, and things are translated here, this is good. You can even fix the translation, but I need to fix the link to the right thing. So you see a German translation here. We can even check the Chinese translation. I hope this is the right one, Chinese Taiwan. Here is some work to do. Some Chinese some Chinese users here, please click the translate description. Oh no, I need to fix it first and then you click it. But you can also find other means to access the DDTP's server than from these pages. It's just one way to enter. We have Hemin Astro. They have a little bit different design for their page. It's also nice. It's more modern. But for me, I like to provide more information. Oh no, I wanted to go to packages. Astro, I prefer education because this is something I have chances to understand. And then you can click here to enhance the information. So the advantage of this web layout is that you have a short overview and then you can go into detail. It's a design decision. Probably more modern what's what I have, but I was used to this. So more questions. Oh no, we are running out of time. No question anymore. Thank you very much for joining me in the early morning. See you later.